you're reading or thinking. And I appreciate that you brought up Tony Robbins, because I listened to some of his stuff back in the day. And there's so many great people out there for people to listen to and be influenced by.
Like you.
Well, let's hope so. We want people to chase their dreams, right?
Exactly. You're doing great stuff here.
Let's go through your book real fast and what it's about and where people can get it. And you said you just finished your first book, and it sounds like you've got an incredible story.
Sure.
Yeah.
So basically, it's not out. Sorry, go ahead. Were you going to ask a question about that? Sorry.
Yeah, I was just going to say, are we going to find it online, or where are we going to get this thing at?
Okay, so I'm publishing it. It's going to be out this fall. As of now, it's called, I think this is the first time I'm saying the name, so obviously you did something here.
Awesome.
Hope you're having a great day. I know I am. That could change, but that's what it is right now. And basically what it is every chapter is it's basically my life and the adversity and challenges and obstacles I had to go to get to where I am today. This is the best place of my life. But trust me, aside from my childhood, I went through a divorce. I'm a single parent, common, but definitely difficult. I lost two parents unexpectedly within a year of each other, and then many other things along the way. And each chapter, at the end of each chapter, I give a summary of sort of what's the takeaway here. You know, we need to focus on forgiveness, gratitude, self-love, self-help, whatever it is. And then I give tips and takeaways for you to implement into your own life. And they're simple, they're basic, and they're uncomplicated. And all I ever say is find one that you like and get started. It doesn't matter if it's my book or someone else's book, just get started. So the summary of it is it's basically all the challenges I went through, how I got through them in a kind of uncomplicated, simplistic way to make it user-friendly for each of you. And I'm being really vulnerable in it. It's not easy. I'm like every day I go back and forth. Do I put this out there? Do I not put it out there? Because it's a lot of really intimate and personal things that I went through. But I think my mission is bigger than my ego. So it's time to get it out there.
Well, again, it sounds like a great book and a great learning tool. I love, again, you've said so many things that have resonated with me, but when you talk about just getting started, I often use my podcast as an example to get started. It wasn't something that I personally wanted to do, but I did it for a business reason to support my online activities, and I didn't know anything about it, and I just got started. I just recorded my first show 2.5 years ago, not knowing a thing about podcasting, and here we are, 40,000 subscribers and over 200 shows, and it proves that you can create a body of work by just getting started. And that is one of my favorite lines to tell people. Don't wait for anybody else. Get started now. Go after it. It's yours to conquer. And thank you for reiterating that. Anything you can touch on about your coaching to share with others if they want to get in touch with you, or even one more last helpful hint for people? Because this has been such a powerful call and the learnings that people can take away from the show so far.
Okay, well, first I just wanted, before you just said all that stuff about yourself really quickly, and the viewers are probably like, yeah, but he knows how to do something. And I was the same as you. I just started, I don't like doing my videos. I don't watch them. I didn't love doing the podcast. I was uncomfortable, but I love that you, first of all, have 40,000 subscribers is amazing. So give yourself a pat on the back for that. But second of all, meaning you or me, we're just like everyone else out there watching this. We just did something. We took action. We got started. And I think it's really important to know that anyone that you look up to, they were just like you at one point, and they just made a decision to do something different. And you can too. And also, I just wanted to congratulate you on your success, because this is not an easy industry. And it's intimidating, it's overwhelming, it's being vulnerable, it's putting your heart out on the line, but you're doing it for a bigger purpose. So kudos to you.
I appreciate that.
And no problem. And in terms of, coaching, I love to help people transform their lives. It's all about evoking transformation and holding space for someone else to do that. And that's what I try to do. But more importantly, what I want to say is less about, you know, promoting myself and my own business, and more about each one of the viewers or listeners who are paying attention to this podcast. And that's that life is so short. It's long and it's short, but we are here, and this is a gift. And when you can get out of the haze of what we've been taught and conditioned and see when you look outside, oh my God, look at the beauty of nature. Look at the beauty of this tree. Look at the gift we're given and we're here to enjoy it for a limited amount of time. What are you waiting for? Why are you worrying about what your peers are going to say or what people are going to think? You may not know what you're here for. You may not know what your purpose is, but start working on it. Start thinking about it. Start asking yourself questions about it. Start getting in alignment. And when you start to feel good and joy and enjoying what you're doing, that's when you know you're on the right track. When you're not feeling good, when you're dreading going to work, when you're dreading going home to your partner, changes need to be made. Whatever those changes are, I'm not saying you need to get out of the situation, but you need to make adjustments. So listen to your body. It talks to you all the time. That's my last takeaway.
I love it. Well, I can tell that I'm going to want to talk to you again after the book comes out to hear your story, to recap it, and, you know, honestly, to get a little bit more of the energy that you've exuded on the show, because that's what I feed off of. That's what I love to do, because I can already tell when people hear this show, they're going to pick up on some of these little tips you've given today. And I shouldn't even say little, these major tips you've given today. And hopefully it'll change your day. So, Pam, thank you so much for taking the time today to be on the show and share the part of your story and give us just enough to go out and get that book. So please.
Thank you. Thanks for having me. It was great. And we'll definitely do something again. Collaborate.
My pleasure. Thank you for listening to today's show. It is my pleasure and honor to interview all of the guests that have been on the Answer Is Yes podcast. If you have enjoyed the show, please go on iTunes and subscribe, give a rating, or simply tell a friend about the show. We also believe in the message of our guests and the positive influence of their stories. As my own mentor and coach, David Meltzer, has taught me, spend some time every day thinking and writing about the things in your own life that you have more than enough of. You will find out how blessed we really are. Please visit my website, livelifedriven.com, for the latest updates about me and what I'm doing. Plus, I post a monthly blog about the many topics on this show. This podcast can also be found there. As I learned early on in life, what you believe is what you will achieve. Thanks, Mark Victor Hansen, and thank you, and have a great week.